go to work. For me, the earliest memory of me is of learning the principle of hard work. And I love football, right? Growing as a little kid, I always wanted to be a professional football player, right? So I remember growing up in high school, football was life, okay? You know, I was the one who came to practice early. I was the one who stayed late. I didn't remember, guys, during lunchtime, while everyone is eating lunch, I'm out there running the bleachers. I'm out there jump roping in the middle of lunch, working hard because I knew that if I were ever going to achieve anything, it was going to come by hard work, right? Hard work, right? So here's this quick story. So my sophomore year, I actually got the starting left tackle or left guard position as a sophomore, right? 2 games into the season, I actually lost that position, right? Coach was like, man, you suck, get up. Right? But here's the thing. I remember going home that day, told my dad. My dad was like, you know what, son? Right, this is the thing. And we had a favorite wrestler. Like, this is the quote. He said, son, you are the best there is, the best there was, the best there ever will be. See, I'm grateful my dad taught me that. I'm grateful that he told me that day, because I could have easily just, you know what, I suck, you suck. Right? But because he taught me that, right, I went to practice the very next day with that mindset of me being the best. Right? Every day, did the same thing, day in, day out, working hard, working my butt off, working hard every single down, every single practice. Did I start that year? No. I never started the game, ever, that sophomore year. But the following season, as a junior, I got my decision back. Right? And so here's the thing, guys. Sometimes, rarely do you ever see the results, right, that you put in during the day at night. Right? Hard work, the results come at the end. Okay? When you put in the work, when you deserve it. You look at the proof, guys. You look at Neil, at Brandon, you look at Jalen, Steve, Brigo, right? At the Murrays, the Bastilles, you know. They're proof that hard work does really, it helps you. They're proof, right? Because they deserve it, right? You don't reap something because you need it. You reap something because you deserve it. You put the work in, right? Well, how would it be like for you to go out in the field and tell the field, hey, I need a crop, just because I need it, right? And so here's what the field says, right? Who's this fool trying to come over here and ask for a crop without even seeds, right? So you must plant the seeds through your hard work, right? Hard work. So the next thing, last one, this is why I feel is after building a mindset and working hard, this is what's going to keep you in this business, right? It's your why. It's why do you do what you do, okay? So the name of the game is results, right? The reason why you're here today is because you want a result, right? And so here's what the Bible says, right? Adam and Eve, they were commanded to be fruitful. Fruitful is an interesting word. Okay, here's what I think fruit, it denotes abundance. Here's what I think fruitful means, is to go to work to produce more than what you need. To go to work, to be fruitful, more than what you need. For what? So that you can bless your people. So that you can bless your company. So you can bless your community. So I can bless my Samoan people, my church, my family, my community, the world, my city. Right? What would it be like if there were millions of crusaders in this world? Wouldn't things be a whole lot different? Of course, right? See, that's my why. I'm not just here just to make money, right? But I'm here to make an impact. I'm here to produce myself to a certain point so much that I can produce value for other people, right? What would it be like to be in a room filled, right? This is why I love this business, because in a room filled with tens and 20s and 30s of strong or successful minded, like-minded business people, right? Now we can turn back around and impact the community. Now we can see, man, what can we do to get back? What can we do now, right, to make a difference in the world, right? But see, guys, this is the thing, right? And I want to share with you guys what I say to myself every single day, right? And this is a little bit personal, but I'm going to share with you guys, right? This is what I tell myself. I am a God. I am like a God. I am like a God. And think about this, guys, right? If we are created in His image, if we can inherit everything that He has, right, then we are great, right? Right? Why would we If we have the potential to be become just like him, why do we consistently, or why do we operate at a lower level? Right? We need to operate at a higher level. We need to live up to our greatness, live up to what we've been, what we're made of. Right? We are made of intelligent matter, guys. We are great. Greatness is within us, and we should live like that.